Parental Responsibility, Wikipedia article audio. In the nations of the European Union and in the United Kingdom, parental responsibility refers to the rights and privileges which underpin the relationship between a child and either or both of the child's parents or those adults who are granted parental responsibility by either signing a parental responsibility agreement with the mother or getting a parental responsibility order from a court. The terminology for this area of law now includes matters dealt with as contact and residence in some states. In European states, Scotland, United Kingdom. In Scots law, issues relative to parental responsibilities are dealt with under the Children Act 1995, which provides for the making of residence, contact, and specific issue orders. These may be applied for by anyone with an interest in a child, not merely parents. Under Section 1 of the 1995 Act, parental responsibilities are, where practicable and in the best interests of the child, 2. These responsibilities last until the child is aged 16, with the exception of the responsibility to provide the child with appropriate guidance, which lasts until the child is aged 18. Under Section 2 of the 1995 Act, those with parental responsibilities are given correlative rights to allow them to fulfill those responsibilities. These rights are: having PRRs entitles a parent to take key decisions relating to the child, such as where they will live and go to school, and what medical treatment they should receive. In addition, parents have an obligation to provide financial support for their children under the Family Law Act 1985 and the Child Support Act 1991. In certain circumstances, this obligation continues when the child in question is beyond the age at which the parents have parental responsibilities under Section 1 of the 1995 Act. The child's mother and the child's father, if he is married to the mother at the time of the child's conception or subsequently, have automatic rights. In line with Scottish Law Commission proposals in 1992, the Family Law Act 2006 has brought Scots law in line with English law to the extent that an unmarried father will obtain parental rights and responsibilities if he is registered as the father on the birth register. A married father's PRRs continue after divorce, unless they are specifically removed by a court. If unmarried fathers or step-parents do not have PRRs, they must either make a Section 4 agreement, or apply to the court under Section 11 for rights. According to the Children Act 1989, Section 3, parental responsibility means all the rights, duties, powers, responsibilities, and authority which by law a parent of a child has in relation to the child and his property. Section 2 states that if the mother and father are married to each other at the time of birth, both acquire parental responsibility, otherwise, the mother automatically acquires it and the father has three ways of acquiring it. A. He becomes registered as the child's father according to specific paragraphs or subparagraphs in the Births and Deaths Registration Act 1953, the Registration of Births, Deaths, and Marriages Act 1965, or the Births and Deaths Registration Order 1976. He and the child's mother make a parental responsibility agreement in which he acquires parental responsibility for the child or the court orders that he shall have parental responsibility for the child. This act also states the process for second female parents and step-parents to acquire parental responsibility as well as the appointment of guardians. A court can only appoint a guardian to a child who has no parent with parental responsibility for him/her or if the individual with whom a child was to live according to an applicable child arrangement order has died. Parental responsibility cannot be transferred or surrendered, completely or in part. Individuals may delegate the responsibility to someone else, but this doesn't mean that they aren't responsible anymore. In other words, they would still be liable for the child. Safeguard and promote the child's health, development, and welfare. Provide the child with appropriate direction and guidance. Maintain personal relations and direct contact with the child. Act as the child's legal representative. To have the child living with him or her or otherwise to regulate the child's residence. To appropriately control, direct or guide the child's upbringing, if the child is not living with him or her, to maintain personal relations and contact with the child on a regular basis, to act as the child's legal representative.